context-free grammar. Context-free grammar, this is models of computation. You know, the models of computation and Langer equation is side by side. This is the type 3 grammar as per Noam Chomsky. This is the pushdown automata and it is a context-free language. Nearer to regular language is deterministic context-free language, then the non-deterministic context-free language. Deterministic context-free language examples is balanced parenthesis, a to the power n, b to the power n, expression grammar. One more thing is expression grammar, it can be run by deterministic context-free grammar. And non-deterministic context-free grammar, the most valid example is, most relevant example is palindrome. Compilers, mainly all our programming languages are more or less fully dependent on deterministic context-free grammar with unambiguous grammar. So that parsing tree from left hand should be one and only, or right hand should be one and only. And then come the Turing machine. You see here, generally linear bounded automata should be the next stage for the context sensitive language, but like the example grammar is a to the power n, b to the power n, c to the power n, WW language. But most of the literature, some of the books, they generally directly jump to the type 1 grammar. That is, this is type 3, this is type 2. Type 2 has two part, deterministic context free, non-deterministic context free, and directly go to the type 1. But there is another grammar that is called type 1. This is this is a combination. This is type 3, this is type 2, and this is type 1 and type 0 combined. And this is the Turing machine is there. This is the Turing machine, but here should be one part should be linear bounded Turing machine, linear bounded automata. So the bound should be there. If there is no bound, that is a Turing machine. So they are almost same. So most of the literature, they are common. Here, one thing we must tell, in regular grammar, we cannot have phase structure grammar. It is one kind of phase structure, very limited. Say a to the power n, b or a b to the power n. But Noam Chomsky first introduced the term, the phase structure grammar. The phase structure grammar, the left hand side is string, right hand side is string. If there is no restriction, so that is called the type 0 grammar. And here the context free grammar, that is the type 2 grammar, it is a type 3. The restriction is left hand side should be a single non-terminal or variable, and right hand side it should be a terminal and then a variable, that is right linear grammar or a terminal. And the context free grammar, one interesting thing is any context free grammar I have discussed, it can be converted to Chomsky's normal form. To be simpler, it should be like any context free grammar, left hand side should be a single variable, right hand side two variable, and or a single terminal. This is the Noam Chomsky's form, is the one, the base form. So that all context free grammar can be converted to this, and so that only start variable kun can go to epsilon or null string, no other variable is allowed to null string. This is, there is an algorithm for it, so that can be done. So this is the way, easy way to remember. And you see that if a goes to epsilon, only in that case only the mod of, that is length of the right hand, can be less than left hand, no other cases. But in the context sensitive grammar, almost same rule, but left hand side we have context sensitive. So variable come with another variable, or variable comes with terminal. But that rule is also same, that only the start variable can go to epsilon, but no other kind of value, no other variable can go to epsilon. But if there is, this restriction is taken off, so that this length and this length has no relation, so then we call the type 0 grammar, which is very tough, that only we can solve by Turing machine. And if there is an algorithm, that the Turing machine can solve it. But it is parsing is very difficult. Parsing not only with difficult, here the parsing is finite state automata, it is on, pushdown automata, it is maximum on cube, n is number of terminals. But for deterministic context free grammar and unambiguous grammar for high level languages, we, by clever technique, we can make it on. And here it is, again it is not NP complex problem, it is more than NP complex, but very tough to parsing. So that is the reason most of the programming language doesn't use this. I have already seen Chomsky type 0, type 1, type 2, type 3 grammar. Here, this is the called the phase structure grammar is introduced. That is the, you first feel it only for the context free grammar, so that you can have a meaningful sentence like Mary wants to eat spaghetti today. So it is a sentence is consist of noun phrase and verb phrase and then adverb. So this is, and then you can even the verb phrase can contain a, again a verb and like this. So it can have a verb phrase can contain verb phrase, noun phrase can count also verb phrase can also noun phrase. So these kinds of embedded things, this kind of embedded thing, it is not possible in regular grammar. Regular grammar, it all should be like a to the power n b. So all a's and then b, or all a to the power n, b to the power n. No, you cannot build in within it like a to the power n, b to the power relation. That is we call the phase structure grammar. But definitely regular grammar is very subset of phase structure grammar. But phase structure grammar comes from covers all type 0 grammar, type 1, type 2, type 3. That is the, that is Noam Chomsky in 1957 to 1959, he introduced the phase structure grammar. Like another example, like the boy played with the ball, this noun phrase and verb phrase, and this is a phase structure. So this is a finite state grammar, that is regular grammar. You can have only this, but here in phase structure grammar, that and so you can built in like a to the power n and b to the power n. This is the same thing. Here it is the mention, that is the length restriction. Here I am taking it the Michael Sifson's book, that is any meaningful language, written language, first written language, consider written language, particularly English is very suitable for context free grammar, but not Bengali or Hindi, but English is, that is the reason English is very popular in programming. So that is the reason you see the Python is almost like English language. So it is a sentence, noun phrase and verb phrase. Noun phrase consists of complex noun, complex noun phrase. So you can have a meaningful sentence. You can make many meaningful sentences. Like article can be a or the. A noun can be boy, girl, flower. Verb can be touches, likes, sees. With using this, you can make a meaningful sentence. Or a sentence can be parsed with this kind of grammar, and this is definitely a context-free grammar. Why? Left-hand side only you see the single variable, and right-hand side either two variable or variable terminal. So this is definitely not context-sensitive grammar. It is a context-free grammar, which is simpler and which can be parsed away in by clever trick. See, this is here a to the power n, b to the power n. This is the its production rules. And you can see it is a phase structure grammar, and this definitely by looking at it, you can see the tree cannot be unambiguous. It cannot be ambiguous grammar. So this is very good example of say here is example is 0 to the power n slash 1 to the power n, almost same as a to the power n, b to the power n. And you can, by using these productions, you can use 0 to the power n hash 1 to the power n. You may represent the same by parse tree. This is, I have taken examples of context free grammar. This is a parenthesis grammar, and this is also a unambiguous grammar. That is great, because most of our programming have this parenthesis. This is more, you will give an example of parenthesis grammar. A start variable, this is, you can see, you can have balance parenthesis comes out. Any balance parenthesis can be parsed with this production rules, and you can see the parse tree here. Another most examples of the deterministic context-free grammar is expression grammar. Expression grammar, see here, by using this technique, expression plus term, and we are term, we give the term from factor. So, we are give more importance to multiplication sign, and this is the expression. So, whenever you find the expression plus grammar, then it automatically, it will try to get this value. So, if we put expression plus expression here, then plus and addition and multiplication will have the same importance, but we have general convention is multiplication should have more importance. So that is the reason we have add this rule, so that it should be evaluated first. So in any mathematical expression, term will be first calculated. This is the, you can see it is definitely these are the things. See here, a plus calculate it first. So this should not be, actually should be like multiplication should come first, then addition. So this is this should be our desired a parse tree. So another good example of context-free grammar, the context-free grammar, union of context-free grammar is also context-free grammar. In any programming language, we basically have different start variable, start one with some rules, start two some rules, and we then make a combine this rule, you can make a your new start variable, and it can go S1, S2, so that all the features of the programming language, context-free grammar can be built into this, built into the program. And you remember that whenever you are programming, whenever you program unit, that is your start variable. So whenever you compile a program, main.c, the main.c should be your start variable. Then it consists of various instructions, then that may be S1, S2 like this. That is a 0 to the power n, a to the power n, or a to the power n, b to the power n language. Say, or this is the basically combination of, it is a two context free grammar. This is one context free grammar, and this is one context free grammar. Either 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n, or 1 to the power n, 0 to the power n. So we can have a like this, this kind of rule. So S can go to S1 or S2, and then S1 rules can be built in here, S2 rules can be there. So it's basically this grammar is basically can any string here. The string W is derived ambiguously, that I have told, in context-free grammar, if it has two or more different leftmost variations. So one and only one leftmost variation is needed. If there are, you can combine, you can two derivations for a single sentence, same sentence, then it must be ambiguous grammar, and that is not acceptable for programming languages. But some grammar like this kind, but one thing is there, a language can have many grammar, but if one grammar can be found unambiguous, then we call it language is that language and grammar is unambiguous. But it is, you have to find it out. There is no rule in that, obvious rule, but certain grammar are definitely ambiguous. You cannot find any grammar so that it's unambiguous. So this kind of grammar, like a to the power I, b to the power j, c to the power k, I equal to j or j equal to k, it will be always ambiguous. You cannot find. So certain grammar are inherently ambiguous, like this kind of grammar. Certain grammar are not ambiguous, but you have to find the proper unambiguous rules for this. This Chomsky's normal form is left hand side only single variable, right hand side only two variables or terminal, and only start variable can go to F7. Any context-free grammar language is generated by context-free grammar is Chomsky's normal form. That every context-free grammar can be converted to Chomsky's normal form. This is as per the Sifser's book. The any another thing is any context-free grammar can be mapped to a pushdown automata. A deterministic context-free grammar to deterministic pushdown automata, and non-deterministic context-free grammar to non-deterministic pushdown automata. As per Sifser's diagram, this is the diagram, this is the finite state machine, these are the stack, this is the end of stack marker, but I like the next diagram, I like this diagram. This is the Sifser's diagram, this diagram I like. So here you can see this is the input tape, and this is the direction only on the left to right, not like Turing machine, it can go into left to right or right to left, it can only read, it is only a read head, and this is your finite state machine, this is your transition function, and this is your state, and this is your stack. And here the end of stack marker is Z0, in certain literature you can see dollar, so both is accepted. In some of the books is a dollar is the end of stack marker, and some of the books Z0. And you can only have push or pop, and only that variable is visible to this finite state machine. So any particular state of the machine, configuration of the machine can be determined by its state, the top of the stack value, and this variable. These three determines whether this finite state machine whether push or pop, and whether it goes to accepting state. And remember, at the it has to cover left to right once, it cannot go back and forth,
And at the end, when it will end, it must go to the accept state. If there is the accept state, and then the, we can say, and also stack should be empty. So there should be no values there, head should be here, and then we can say the this string is accepted by this push notification.